What's going on, guys, and welcome back to part two of the Toyota Tacoma LS Swap Build Series. Today, our goal is going to be to get this poopy old four-cylinder engine and transmission out of the truck to make way for our 6.0 LS engine. I also want to get the LS engine on a stand and possibly get it all torn apart and get it inspected, see what all it's going to need. So without further ado, let's get to it. So we got the engine and transmission out. I got the exhaust out, drive shaft, everything's sitting over there. Right now I'm just taking out all the old brake lines and things like that because I'm gonna run all new ones. I removed the power steering lines. I'm gonna save those because I'm gonna reuse this rack and pinion. So I'm gonna adapt the GM power steering pump to this rack and pinion. So I'm probably gonna use those lines. I'm going to try and make new ones, but I'll utilize those somehow. I'll probably reuse the ends and fabricate new lines. So, yeah, let's just continue here, taking things apart. And, yeah, let's go.
So we got the frame completely stripped. We're gonna go ahead, we pushed it outside because there's nothing else I can really do with it until I get the rest of my parts. So we're gonna go ahead and get the engine on a stand and start getting it all torn down.
What do you think, dude? Yeah.
All right, Nate, so how these work is, right, you get your crankshaft that drives, you get your crankshaft drives the pistons up and down on the bore.
I got everything from
so these are your valves. So the valves, you'll see when we pull the heads off, but the valves are inside the cylinder, they stick up.
He needs a collar.
So you have
a collar and a leash.
A rocker arm. That mounts to those like saddles, right? And you get a push rod. Now this works. You have what's called a lifter inside, and then you get your camshaft. Right, you know what a camshaft looks like? It has lobes. They're like oblong lobes. So as the camshaft's spinning, it pushes the lifters up and down, which pushes the push rod up and down.
So what happens is it pushes the rocker arm. When the rocker arm pivots, it pushes down on the valve and opens it.
Huh?
It's all timed.
You're welcome.
So everything's timed. Open and close at the exact time that it needs to. So we got the block all torn down. It looks really good. It obviously needs cleaned up. You know, the outside of it's pretty rusty. So what I'm gonna do there is I'm going to sandblast it and put a coat of POR15 on it, which is stuff I've used in the past. I actually used it on my wife's Tahoe. I did an LS build on that, and I used that stuff. I really like it a lot. I've used it many a times. It's honestly the best coating, in my opinion, other than maybe powder coat. So we're gonna do that. There was some wear on these cam bearings, which we're putting a new cam in it anyways. I have a Texas Speed cam on the way. So I ordered a set of cam bearings that I'm gonna install. Those are on the way. The cylinders are in really good shape. There's actually still a lot of cross hatching still in them. So we're just gonna run a ball hone through those, clean those up. And yeah, other than that, that's pretty much it for the block. Pistons all look really good. I started cleaning these up. Those are the ones I haven't cleaned yet. I have a couple here that I've cleaned, as you can see. They came out really nice. Here's one that I haven't cleaned yet. Still, there's a lot of stuff baked on, a lot of carbon on these. I was kind of experimenting with some different solvents and stuff. This is just lacquer thinner that I use to clean my paint guns. And it works really good. I basically just let these soak overnight, and then I pulled them out, scrubbed them with like a
like a brush and it comes right off. I use a piece of, I always do this, I use a piece of the old piston ring and run it through the ring lands and get all the carbon that's baked into there. And it comes off really nice. So I've seen a lot of guys use some different stuff, oven cleaner or things like that, but I don't know, this works pretty good for me. I let it soak, like I said, overnight, and it really loosens everything up and they come out really nice and clean with very little effort. I did do a little bit of bead blasting. I just worked on the timing cover a little bit, but that's pretty much it. I got pretty much all my engine parts over here. This is all stuff that, you know, some of this I'm gonna be reusing. I'm gonna be reusing the rocker arms. I have a trunnion upgrade kit that I'm gonna put, I'm gonna use on those. Everything else, the lifter valley cover, I'll probably reuse. I'll probably bead blast that. The rear cover, the alternator, I think the truck alternator will work. I'm doing a, not sure if I mentioned it or not, but I'm doing a F-body front accessory drive, which will give me a lot more clearance from the accessories to the front of the truck, to the, you know, so I can fit a radiator in there. But I think that alternator will work with my front accessory drive, my F-body front accessory drive. I have a new oil pump on the way. Actually, it's already here. I still have to order my timing chain, timing gear. Trying to see what else. I think that's pretty much it. These are all my old parts, which, you know, I'm probably gonna sell these cylinder heads. I'm gonna clean those up. There's a bunch of broken exhaust manifold studs in those. I'll probably get those out, clean those up, try and sell them. The old oil pan's not gonna work for this application. So I actually have a new oil pan that I'm gonna use, which I'll probably show in the next video. And the truck intake isn't gonna work on this because I have, it's not gonna give me enough clearance. So I'm not gonna be using that, you know, just the rest of this is, a lot of this is stuff I'm not gonna be reusing. I'm probably gonna reuse the old truck manifolds because, you know, honestly, those flow pretty good. I'm just gonna clean those up. And then I have that wiring harness that I need to do something with. I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna use the factory PCM factory harness, and I'm just gonna basically do a kind of a custom harness. I'm gonna have to cut that harness all up and make it look nice and eliminate a lot of the stuff on it that I don't need. I would love to go with like a Holley. Like Holley makes a Terminator, I believe it's like the Terminator X, which is really nice, just plug and play. It comes with a new ECU, comes with the harness and everything, and they're really nice. And they're actually not a bad price. I think it's like $1,000, which is a really good deal. But you know, I'd like to save some money where I can. So I think I'm just going to reuse the ECU that I got with this engine and the harness. But who knows? I could change my mind. So that's pretty much it.
All right, guys. So that is going to be it for this video. I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button, drop a comment down below, let me know what you think. Also, don't forget to share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future content. But with that, until next time, see you later.